Welcome back to Pinoy Crossover. The last topic of today is all about the Raptors. Kawhi's maintenance days, his chillax days, his relaxing days. That's what I envision. What do you guys think about his maintenance days? Let's go with James.
Just let him rest. I think because it gives Siakam to be a leader. I mean, it made him to be a leader. Mm. Same thing with Lowry, because Lowry's last 2 years is down. Like, his average is going down. So it gives them time to be a better team without Kawhi. So if Kawhi, just if you put Kawhi there, it's going to be like crazy good, right? Mm. But for this one, because Siakam, I think Siakam should be option number two. Mm-hmm. Over Lowry. If you guys want to make it to Promised Land, to the championship, I think Siakam should be option number two because Lowry had his time with the Raptors. So I guess this time I think let it.
I like how you say Promised Land. Yeah. Like,
I've never. It's the Promised Land.
Trust the Promised Land.
And hey, he did hit a buzzer beater, a nice lefty buzzer beater for us. So
it was just a little thing on that. Yeah. It was like surprising how Nick Nurse or maybe the coaching staff trusted in like Pascal. Give the ball to Pascal. Do the usual high off the glass layup, and he made it buzzer beater, a game winner. But speaking of Kawhi's maintenance days, as a diehard Raptors fan, like, why are you still? You look like you're healthy now. So you can start playing with the Raptors team, get build up chemistry before the playoffs. But you got to understand, he did come off a season or almost a career ending injury. So, you know, a few days ago, Bobby Webster came out through reports saying how when he came in July 20th, Kawhi Leonard, the coaching staff and the medical staff had a plan for Kawhi in. These are the games you're gonna be playing, and these are the days you're gonna be resting here and there. They have like every 2 weeks, the head athletic trainer, medical staff, they give Kawhi a schedule of like, this is your schedule for the rest of the week. Maybe just like, for example, this past week, this is the schedule for the rest of the week. You're not gonna play Phoenix, you're not gonna play for Memphis, you're gonna play here against Friday against Houston. So, and then they're also talking to him about how are you feeling, Kawhi, how's your knee feeling, making sure he's all right. But I understand, like, some Raptors fans are still a little bit panicking just because he's not playing a lot. Mm-hmm. He's already missed, like, 13 games out of the 70 games that are remaining, right? You have to build that chemistry up before the playoffs. Mm-hmm. But you got to understand, Kawhi's rest, we're going to need him in the playoffs. We shouldn't rely on him too much, but we're going to need him still in the playoffs. And reach the promised land.
What does this mean for, because he's missing games, so what's that, the thought about him, the MVP candidacy is kind of out of the window.
I don't think he's focused on that. Yeah, but my take is for him is that, I agree too, not in sort of resting him, but why can't we just reduce the amount of minutes that he played? Why do we have, because we need this kind of chemistry. If we just reduce the amount of minutes for him to play, because he's been playing, like, I noticed a 35, 38 game, he's been playing a lot of minutes. Why can't we just reduce it? Because of the fact that they, you know, he needs to get used to just the rolling. Because a lot of the fact that you need to build that chemistry with the team, not just that, but you got to show the team that you're not, you know, because a lot of people calling him soft because he's just choosing to rather.
You know,
he's
not, you know,
and he'd rather not say nothing. He, you know, he's with Embiid. He was getting these planned rest for him, but he's vocal about it. He's saying, "I want to play. I want to play." I've never heard Kawhi saying he wants to play. Like, it goes to show, if that's your best player and he chooses just to, "Oh, I'm just gonna play it safe."
Yeah.
Like, what are you gonna do during the playoffs? Is he gonna play it safe too? If something, let's say he gets like a sprain. And all of a sudden, he's just gonna choose to sit out. Like, I want to see him fight to play. Like, because I don't want to see him in the playoffs because it's gonna get more physical. He's gonna get banged up. I don't know if he's gonna choose to play, because that will tell us whether he really wants to stay for the Raptors. Because if he gets dinged up during the playoffs, maybe a sprained ankle, like what happened during the playoffs with the Warriors, is he just gonna sit it out because he knows, hey, my health comes first, right? So my take is, reduce the amount of minutes. But choose to play, like say something, and that you choose to play on this, because he's just literally, I know he's quiet, but say something.
Hey, he's smiling a lot now.
You won't hear him through the media, but at least he's talking to the medical staff.
Just for me, I have him in fantasy, so I'm
What are you guys' thoughts about the Raptors playing better without him? There's also that kind of topic around the channels.
That's good. You know why? Because as long as the team is playing well, and then once Kawhi comes in, hopefully the chemistry is there, and then Kawhi, when they implement Kawhi, they'll be a fledged, you know, good team that's going to make it to the championship game. But, you know, obviously there's some ramifications where it comes to Kawhi having the ball more and then reduced minutes or reduced plays throughout the squad, like Pascal, Kyle Lowry, maybe in the bench mob, that CJ Miles, you know, he's been playing well, but his minutes might go down just because when Kawhi comes back, he's going to take over the minutes.
But don't you think the staff is just doing that because they don't want to have another Spurs problem? Like, when Spurs had something to say about Kawhi and then Kawhi was just not showing up, don't you think that's the same problem?
That's what the plan they made out. They'll have a plan throughout the rest of the season about this is going to be your days that you're going to be resting, these are the days that you're going to play. But obviously there's another argument that's like, if it's the same thing with the reduced minutes, why not him don't even participate in some of the practices or have him have light practices?
That's what they do with older guys, like Dwayne Wade just doesn't even come to practice. I'm like, why don't you just not make Kawhi go to practice? Like, just play.
They might have had light practices for him, or even he just tells them like, don't come to practice at all. But we don't know. The media doesn't really know, right? We just have to see from eye to eye. It's like, oh, Kawhi's over there practicing while shooting his free throws.
Mark, your issue is you want to see his drive to play.
Yeah.
Like, you want to
see
his drive.
They're just so careful with him. If he's your best player, if he has that leadership, you should, you know, you're setting an example for your team that, hey, like, my health comes first before the team, and then Mike, you know, I choose these, and then what does that say about your team? If you're a leader of you're the best player on the Raptors, you should be setting an example for your team, and then this is the kind of example that I'm seeing. Like, I understand that you're being careful with him because he's a one-year, he could be a one-year rental. He could be a one-year rental, but if that's the case, like, hey, like, I just want to see some more, you know,
it's a
leadership.
Raptors fan dilemma right now.
It's tough. Like, it's tough when your best player is the, like, you know, it's treated like glass in a sense.
And like, what if all this rest, all this maintenance days, like, it's not gonna pay off, right? Exactly, with that 1 year rental, basically, almost, right? What if this doesn't translate in the playoffs, and then Kawhi and his other teammates just, you know, same thing as last year and the year before that, we're not gonna make a deep run in the playoffs. And
what if
again?
Kawhi buys a house in San Diego?
I'm liking how Siakam is taking over, though.
Plus seven,
and that's higher than Klay Thompson, McCollum, and even Leonard. So for something like that, that's a really a good asset for you guys. The Raptors is really just...
Yeah. Pascal Siakam, MIP, hands down.
Yeah. Worst case scenario, if Kawhi leaves, at least we have
Siakam.
That's where we get Bradley
the
Beal.
And then we'll beat Philadelphia for sure.
All right, we're coming to an end. Let's just give shout-outs. James, anyone you'd like to shout-out?
I want to shout-out my family. Shout-out the family in Philippines and Canada and U.S. So,
there you go.
We got family everywhere.
Yeah, family everywhere. Do you have anything you'd like to?
Yeah, man. Just keep following us. Join in the conversation. What do you guys think about Kawhi's maintenance days? What do you think about the Oladipo, Alonzo injuries? And what do you think about the NBA All-Star game that's coming up and NBA All-Star starters and reserves that are going to be announced very, very soon?
Marky Mark, anything you'd like to add? Well, just follow us on Instagram, guys. Pinoy Crossover, YouTube, Facebook. You can find us everywhere. And we might be starting back our website, too. So we're going to post some articles. Mm-hmm. Keep tuning in that.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you guys for tuning in to Pinoy Crossover. We're just sharing our opinions. Make sure you join the community. And yeah, stay ballin'.